The year 2020 is definitely a year that most of us would like to forget about. We lost many of our idols and legends like Kobe Bryant, Chadwick Boseman, to name a few. We've also been restrained to our homes because of the coronavirus. We lost many of our loved ones and haven't been able to meet friends and family who live far away. Hey guys, welcome to Discover X, where you can discover and learn new things. Today we'll be talking about the top countries dealing with COVID-19. Before we go into the video, I want to remind you to drop a like on this video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also, turn on post notifications to never miss a video from us. The world still hasn't recovered from the sufferings due to the pandemic. Many people lost their jobs and income. Many businesses were shut down. However, many nations faced the virus boldly and impressed us with their leadership, while many of the developed countries absolutely failed in fighting the virus. Without further ado, let's get right into the video. Many of the developed countries with immense resources disappointed us a lot with the way they dealt with the virus. Countries like the USA, Italy, India, Spain, Brazil, and the United Kingdom seemed like all their resources had vanished in thin air. More than 21 million cases were reported in the USA. Donald Trump's nonchalance in the face of COVID-19 and refusal to act fast has led the country down a very slippery slope. The US government turned a blind eye to much of the World Health Organization's advice, which included implementing a track and trace system. In Brazil, more than 7 million cases were reported. Even though Brazil had recorded one of the highest death tolls, there was still no national lockdown in Brazil. It couldn't get more ignorant than this. In India, more than 10 million cases were reported. Even though India was quick in taking early actions like lockdown, only a few hours' notices were given to the people, and the people of India were not equipped to cope with this news. The sudden lockdown impacted millions of low-income migrant workers who had been working in cities in search of a better life. Now let's talk about a small number of countries that emerged as pioneers in epidemic response and virus containment efforts. These countries had the best responses to COVID-19. Taiwan. During the initial days of an outbreak, one of the worst situations is when you're a neighbor to the epicenter of a global pandemic. Before the virus was even registered on the radars of some governments, Taiwan was testing and quarantining travelers from Wuhan, China. The island had networks with China, which gave it a clear view of the epicenter of the global pandemic. This enabled them to act early. The government deployed a containment strategy that has proven to be one of the most successful in the world. Rather than shuttering its economy for weeks on end in an attempt to slow the virus, Taiwan went another way. After quickly losing its borders and banning exports of surgical masks, the government used contact tracing and mobile SIM tracking to identify and ensure those in quarantine were actually abiding by the rules. Taiwan maintained a stockpile of face masks, medical officers, and lab capacity to handle any outbreaks prior to the coronavirus pandemic. The country had strengthened its preparations for a pandemic after the outbreak of SARS in 2003, which severely impacted Taiwan. In October, this small country reached a record 200 days without any domestically transmitted cases of COVID-19. The cases which were later reported were mostly from people traveling from Indonesia. The government conducted coronavirus testing on all Indonesian migrant workers undergoing quarantine in quarantine centers. Adopting this strategy meant that Taiwan was able to contain the outbreak. Taiwan has also leveraged its own response into diplomatic outreach, sending other hard-hit countries much-needed medical supplies that it could spare. New Zealand. New Zealand, being an island nation tucked away in a far-flung corner of the globe, gave it some advantage for sure. But New Zealand's rise in the rankings is so much more than good geographic fortune. The country started implementing preventative measures just 3 days after the WHO declared the coronavirus outbreak a public health emergency, on January 30th, 2020. On the 20th of January, the Ministry of Health set up the National Health Coordination Center, NHCC, to respond to the outbreak. An infectious and notifiable diseases order was issued to take effect from 30 January, which required health practitioners to report any suspected cases under the Health Act 1956. This was the first barrier of protection for New Zealand. Less than 3 weeks after the first case was reported, travel restrictions to and from other countries were imposed, and a week later had not only shut down non-essential businesses, but even went further, instituting a level 4 lockdown, which meant that people could only interact with people within their home in an attempt to eliminate the virus altogether. New Zealand committed to an elimination strategy. New Zealanders praised their government's early response and coordinated messaging. The Prime Minister also promised that no one would lose their residence if they lost work. New Zealand's aggressive disease elimination approach really proved useful. Singapore. Singapore was among the first countries which were hailed a winner for its pandemic response, a well-deserved reputation on the back of its aggressive approach to contact tracing, which included scanning people's IDs at supermarkets and widespread testing. Timely preparation, aggressive testing, tracing of carriers, and a bit of luck, all this helped the small nation to limit the impact of COVID-19. Singapore was well prepared because of the lessons they learned from the SARS epidemic. The government tightened border controls immediately after the disease first erupted in China. The government built temporary bed spaces at breakneck speeds to house COVID-19 patients, keeping the casualty rate low. The government also announced that pupils over the age of 7 must use the city-state's contact tracing app or wearable device. Iceland. Iceland was able to tackle COVID-19 without having to implement the type of lockdowns that many European countries had to put in place. Iceland's tiny population was an advantage, but early vigilance and action were very important in keeping the case numbers low. When people talk about the critical importance of testing, Iceland is the clearest example. Following on the heels of its first detected cases by early March, Iceland quickly instituted a broad testing and contact tracing regime to identify and isolate COVID patients, with such good results that they were able to avoid a total shutdown and had schools, museums, and some businesses begin reopening. Unlike most countries, health officials rushed in to contain the spread earlier. Another reason for Iceland being successful was that people actually stayed indoors. If a person was suspected of having the virus, they were told to stay inside while the government covered the individual's full salary. Even though there was a sharp spike in cases, which went from 1 to 55 cases in a week, researchers praised the government for its widespread testing, tracing, and quarantine procedures, as well as fresh restrictions and emphasis on mask wearing to combat this spike. Israel. Israel had inoculated over 20% of its population just 3 weeks into its COVID-19 vaccination drive. This was more than 1.5% reached in Britain or 0.5% in Germany and Canada. At the time of writing, the number of Israelis vaccinated has been more than the number of people who caught the virus. It included more than 55% of those aged 60 and above. This is the power of the world's fastest vaccination drive. It is predicted that the proportion of over 60s among the critically ill will drop from 70% to just 20% by the end of January. News and reports from the Israeli authorities have suggested deals with Moderna, which scaled up to 6 million vaccine doses, AstraZeneca for 10 million, and the current top competitor, Pfizer, for 10 million doses. Israel seemed to have made no compromises when it comes to supplying enough vaccines for the citizens. Ensuring a supply of well over 20 million doses for a country of a rather small population of about 9 million people. The vaccination drive began on December 20th, 12 days after Britain. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu became the first Israeli to be vaccinated live on TV, encouraging others to follow in his footsteps. The Prime Minister said that they aim to reach around 150,000 people a day. The government has stepped up its efforts in targeting disinformation around the vaccine, with medical professionals almost always on TV reassuring people that the vaccine is safe. Facebook took down 4 groups at the start of the vaccination drive for spreading misleading content about the vaccine at the request of the Israeli Justice Ministry. Despite the vaccination drive, Israel became the first country in the world to enter a third full national lockdown, with more countries to follow as the third wave is spreading worldwide. That's it about today's topic. Hope you all liked the video and learned something new. Drop a like and subscribe to see more such content from us. If you think we missed anything or have any questions, do mention them in the comments section. Turn on post notifications to never miss a video from us. Until we see you next time, take care.